The word of Yahuwah that came to Yoel, the son of Pethuel, "Hear this, ye old men, and give ear, all ye inhabitants of the land. Has this been in your days or even in the days of your fathers? Tell ye your children of it, and let your children tell their children, and their children another generation. That which the palmer worm has left has the locust eaten, and that which the locust has left has the cankerworm eaten, and that which the cankerworm has left has the caterpillar eaten. Awake, ye drunkards, and weep and howl, all ye drinkers of wine, because of the new wine, for it is cut off from your mouth. For a nation is come up upon my land, strong and without number, whose teeth are the teeth of a lion, and he has the cheek teeth of a great lion. He has laid my vine waste, and barked my fig tree. He has made it clean bare, and cast it away. The branches thereof are made white. Lament like a virgin girded with sackcloth for the man of her youth. The oblation and the drink offering is cut off from the house of Yahuwah. The priests, Yahuwah's ministers, mourn. The field is wasted. The land mourns, for the grain is wasted. The new wine is dried up. The oil languishes. Be ye ashamed, O ye husbandmen. Howl, O ye vine dressers, for the wheat and for the barley, because the harvest of the field is perished. The vine is dried up, and the fig tree languishes. The pomegranate tree, the palm tree also, and the apple tree, even all the trees of the field, are withered, because joy is withered away from the sons of men. Gird yourselves and lament, ye priests. Howl, ye ministers of the altar. Come, lie all night in sackcloth, ye ministers of my Elohim, for the oblation and the drink offering is withheld from the house of your Elohim. Sanctify ye a fast, call a solemn assembly, gather the elders and all the inhabitants of the land into the house of Yahuwah Elohakim, and cry unto Yahuwah. Alas for the day of Yahuwah is at hand, and as a destruction from El Shaddai shall it come. Is not the meat cut off before our eyes? Yea, joy and gladness from the house of our Elohim. The seed is rotten under their clods. The garners are laid desolate. The barns are broken down, for the grain is withered. How do the beasts groan? The herds of cattle are perplexed, because they have no pasture. Yea, the flocks of sheep are made desolate. O Yahuwah, to you will I cry, for the fire has devoured the pastures of the wilderness, and the flame has burned all the trees of the field. The beasts of the field cry also unto you, for the rivers of waters are dried up, and the fire has devoured the pastures of the wilderness. Blow ye the shofar in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of Yahuwah comes. For it is nigh at hand, a day of darkness and of gloominess, a day of clouds and of thick darkness, as the morning spread upon the mountains, a great people and a strong. There has not been ever the like, neither shall be any more after it, even to the years of many generations. A fire devours before them, and behind them a flame burns. The land is as the Garden of Eden before them, and behind them a desolate wilderness. Yea, and nothing shall escape them. The appearance of them is as the appearance of horses, and as horsemen, so shall they run. Like the noise of chariots on the tops of mountains shall they leap, like the noise of a flame of fire that devours the stubble, as a strong people set in battle array. Before their face the people shall be much pained, all faces shall gather blackness. They shall run like mighty men, they shall climb the wall like men of war, and they shall march everyone on his ways, and they shall not break their ranks, neither shall one thrust another. They shall walk everyone in his path, and when they fall upon the sword, they shall not be wounded. They shall run to and fro in the city, they shall run upon the wall, they shall climb upon the houses, they shall enter in at the windows like a thief. The earth shall quake before them, the heaven shall tremble, the sun and the moon shall be dark, and the stars shall withdraw their shining, and Yahuwah shall utter his voice before his army, for his camp is very great, for he is strong that executes his word. For the day of Yahuwah is great and very terrible, and who can abide it? Therefore also now, says Yahuwah, turn ye to me with all your heart, and with fasting, and with weeping, and with mourning, and rend your heart, and not your garments, and turn unto El Yahuwah Elohakim, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and of great kindness, and repents of the evil. Who knows if he will return and repent, and leave a blessing behind him, even an oblation and a drink offering unto Yahuwah Elohakim. Blow the shofar in Zion, sanctify a fast, call a solemn assembly, gather the people, sanctify the assembly. Assemble the elders, gather the children and those that suck the breasts. Let the bridegroom go forth of his chamber and the bride out of her closet. Let the priest, the ministers of Yahuwah, weep between the porch and the altar, and let them say, spare your people, O Yahuwah, and give not your heritage to reproach, that the heathen should rule over them. Wherefore should they say among the people, where is their Elohim? Then will Yahuwah be jealous for his land and pity his people. Yea, Yahuwah will answer and say unto his people, behold, I will send you grain and wine and oil, and ye shall be satisfied therewith. And I will no more make you a reproach among the heathen, but I will remove far off from you the northern army, and will drive him into a land barren and desolate, with his face toward the east sea, and his hinder part toward the utmost sea. And his stink shall come up, and his ill savor shall come up, because he has done great things. Fear not, O land, be glad and rejoice, for Yahuwah will do great things. Be not afraid, ye beasts of the field, for the pastures of the wilderness do spring, for the tree bears her fruit, the fig tree and the vine do yield their strength. And children of Zion, rejoice and be glad in Yahuwah Elohakim, because he gives to us the righteous teaching which descends on us like a teaching rain and a latter rain in the first of the year. And the floor shall be full of wheat, and the fat shall overflow with wine and oil. And I will restore to you the years that the locust has eaten, the cankerworm and the caterpillar and the palmer worm, my great army which I sent among you, and ye shall eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of Yahuwah Elohakim, that has dealt wondrously with you. And my people shall never be ashamed, and ye shall know that I am in the midst of Yashrael, and that I am Yahuwah Elohakim, and none else. And my people shall never be ashamed. And it shall come to pass afterward, that I will pour out my Ruach upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, your old men shall dream dreams, your young men shall see visions, and also upon the servants and upon the handmaids in those days will I pour out my Ruach, and I will show wonders in the heavens and in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness, and the moon into blood, before the great and terrible day of Yahuwah come. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of Yahuwah shall be delivered, for in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem shall be deliverance, as Yahuwah has said, and in the remnant whom Yahuwah shall call. For behold, in those days and in that time, when I shall bring again the captivity of Yehuda and Jerusalem, I will also gather all nations, and will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat, and will plead with them there for my people and for my heritage, Yashrael, whom they have scattered among the nations and parted my land. And they have cast lots for my people, and have given a boy for a harlot, and sold a girl for wine, that they may drink. Yea, and what have ye to do with me, O Sor and Sidon, and all the coast of Pelesheth? Will ye render me a recompense? And if ye recompense me, swiftly and speedily will I return your recompense upon your own head. Because ye have taken my silver and my gold, and have carried into your temples my goodly pleasant things, the children also of Yehuda and the children of Jerusalem have ye sold unto the Yavanim, that ye might remove them far from their border. Behold, I will raise them out of the place whither ye have sold them, and will return your recompense upon your own head. And I will sell your sons and your daughters into the hand of the children of Yehuda, and they shall sell them to the Shevaim, to a people afar off. For Yahuwah has spoken it. Proclaim ye this among the other nations. Prepare war. Wake up the mighty men. Let all the men of war draw near. Let them come up. Beat your plowshares into swords, and your pruning hooks into spears. Let the weak say, I am strong. Assemble yourselves, and come, all ye heathen, and gather yourselves together round about. Thither, cause your mighty ones to come down, O Yahuwah. Let the heathen be wakened, and come up to the valley of Yehoshaphat. For there will I sit to judge all the heathen round about. Put ye in the sickle, for the harvest is ripe. Come, get you down, for the press is full. The fats overflow, for their wickedness is great. Multitudes, multitudes in the valley of decision. For the day of Yahuwah is near in the valley of decision. The sun and the moon shall be darkened, and the stars shall withdraw their shining. Yahuwah also shall roar out of Zion, and utter his voice from Jerusalem. And the heavens and the earth shall shake. But Yahuwah will be the hope of his people, and the strength of the children of Yisrael. So shall ye know that I am Yahuwah Elohakim, dwelling in Zion, my holy mountain. Then shall Jerusalem be holy, and there shall no strangers pass through her any more. And it shall come to pass in that day that the mountain shall drop down new wine, and the hills shall flow with milk, and all the rivers of Yehuda shall flow with waters, and a fountain shall come forth of the house of Yahuwah, and shall water the valley of Shittim. And Mitzrayim shall be a desolation, and Edom shall be a desolate wilderness, for the violence against the children of Yehuda, because they have shed innocent blood in their land. But Yehuda shall dwell forever, and Jerusalem from generation to generation. For I will cleanse their blood that I have not cleansed. For Yahuwah dwells in Zion.